acts of love. Welcome to the time of relief, the time of revelation, of liberation, the time of empowerment and of favor. As I said in earlier episodes, God is our subject matter on the topic of love. Since God is love, as the Bible says, we need not go far in finding the perfect example of how love works. One of the many myths regarding our Christian perception of love is that agape, one of Greek words for love, describes a special kind of God's love that is supreme, unconditional, and divine. This erroneous assertion has kept a lot of people trapped in relationships in which they are expected to keep on loving their abuser unconditionally. Agape is not the supreme divine love. There are no lesser and higher kinds of love. Love is love and love is divine, either agape, eros, philia, or storge. Agape is not the supreme love. Love is the supreme. Agape is not the unconditional love of God, because God's love is both conditional and unconditional in practice. Don't let yourself be disillusioned that you must only love unconditionally for your love to be genuine. God Himself, that is love Himself, love both ways. Don't be deceived to forgive unrepentant offender and forget what life is teaching you. God never does. Love never does. I do not say this to mean spending the rest of your days whining in hate and bitterness, licking the wounds inflicted on you by others. God never does that. He is not a bitter God. He still loves unrepentant sinner and offender with general love, but will not usher him or her into the inner chambers of his heart, reserved for his choicest bride. He moves on with his life and would sinner repent for his or her own good. Our holier-than-Jesus attitude is the reason why many children of God are victims of and praise for the agents of darkness. Let's take a look at some acts of love as revealed in the scriptures. 1. God's love is both unconditional and conditional. For God had such love, agape, for the world that He gave His only Son, so that whosoever has faith in Him may not come to destruction but have eternal life. We've used ages focusing on the first phrase of this statement, which enumerates the unconditional aspect of God's love, but ignored the rest of the statement that actually define the condition for salvation, whosoever believes in Christ. The unconditional side of God's love do not infringe on the conditional side. They are different sides of the same coin. Lord Jesus also stated in John 10:16, "For this reason doth my Father loves, that is, agape me, because I lay down my life." In other words, there is a reason, a criteria Jesus met that earned him that special place of love, obedience to the Father, even to the death on the cross. Jesus also reiterated this when he said in John 14:21, that obedience to God's commandments makes someone to be loved more than the general level of love, as in John 3:16. Therefore, to avoid being a victim in love, love the way God loves, unconditionally, and open your eyes and also love conditionally. 2. Love doesn't forgive all. Forgiveness is a subject Christians often overflog. God is love and He only forgives those that repent. Jesus said if someone offends you, and you've done all necessary to make peace with him, starting by informing the person, Matthew 18:15-17, and that person remain adamant, you have the right not to forgive him or her. Luke 17:3. It reads, "Give attention to yourselves. If your brother does wrong, say a sharp word to him, and if he has sorrow for his sin, let him have forgiveness." Note what the Lord said, "If he is sorry, let him have forgiveness." Don't give the unrepentant more chance to hurt you. That's an act of love. Of course, the Bible says we should overcome evil with good. That's our first point of call as Christians. But also note that Jesus also acknowledged that this will not always work with all men. There are sons and daughters of perdition. Judas was one. Matthew 18:15-17, I will read only verse 17. "And if he will not give ear to them, let it come to the hearing of the church. And if he will not give ear to the church, let him be to you as a Gentile and a tax farmer." Biblical Jews had no dealings with tax collectors and Gentiles. There are times to define boundaries. 3. Love is an emotion. Don't be deceived that emotion is a sin. God, who is love, is highly emotional. The only thing is that all His decisions are not just based on emotions. We are made in His likeness, so don't deny your emotions. God demonstrates emotions characterized with humans. Love laughed, Psalm 2 verse 4, cried, John 11:35, angered, Mark 3:5, vexed, Isaiah 63 verse 10, remorseful, Genesis 6:6. The failure to embrace the emotional side of love is what kills a lot of relationships. Love lives on gratitude, bad deeds and ungratefulness kills love. When iniquity abound, agape may wax old. Matthew 24 verse 12, invest positively in your love life. God is emotional, agape is emotional, because God is. Feed your love relationships. The food of love is gratitude, is good deeds. The food of God is gratitude. Don't deny emotion, master it. 4. Love reprimand when necessary. Love, genuine love doesn't indulge, it corrects, reprimand when necessary. Hebrews 12 verses 6-9, love need to sever some relationships at times. Jesus did just that many times. God did it many times with Israel, until they repent. Jesus said, regard the unrepentant as a Gentile. When someone is obviously in the wrong and you tell him sorry, instead of the other way around, you are enabling him or her. You empower such individual to be blind to his or her wrong, and to hurt you the more. So be bold enough to correct in love. Message by Reverend Silas Olufemi, Voice, TTS, powered by Time of Relief.